Nigga, you really fucked
it.
Haiti.
And in Haiti. For all we know, Esau probably got more mercenaries and agents down there. And they probably, you know, kidnapping young Jakes.
Yeah.
Sacrificing, doing all types of stuff, man. Getting ready to set up a new puppet leader, you know?
Yeah. Enforce the JAB down there.
Misinformation that's leading to the killing of people. So this devil, he's, and that's why the scriptures tell you how he's very crafty, more crafty than any beast of the field. You know, he's very subtile than any beast of the field, man. That's straight up mind manipulation.
It's
straight up witchcraft. So you better believe once. All he has to do is do the brainwashing part by creating those narratives and just running it through his mainstream medium. And then once enough people buy into it, he can do the rest. Yeah, because that's what he uses on his medium. Satan, that's the medium of Shaitan, Satan. You know? This is all he... All he's doing is setting up snares for the righteous.
Zechariah chapter 11, verse 5. Who possesses slay them and hold themselves not guilty, and they shall sell them, saying, blessed be the Lord, for I am rich, their own shepherds pity them not. So our possessions, we saw even, you know, inoculate these people with these poisons. And when they come back with, you know, symptoms, life-threatening symptoms, you know, and they try to voice their, you know, what this inoculation done to their body, you know, Esau say, oh, it's misinformation.
Yeah.
You know, Esau doesn't hold himself guilty of what he has done on the planet Earth. Exactly. You know, that's why I brought this scripture.
That's it. And that's why that blood is going up. You know, anytime it talks about. Blood crying up to the Father. That's that person's soul crying to the Heavenly Father for a crime that was done against him. Mm. Like Abel.
Yeah.
When Cain killed Abel, the Lord saw that his soul cried out to him.
Like the elect. That it was in Revelations yep, when he says the righteous blood cries unto
yeah. Yeah, that's in 2 Thessalonians 15.
Yep.
Revelation 6. You know, so really you're guilty. That's why the Lord said I would not at all acquit the wicked.
It's a wrong as
well. You know. You spilled a you caused a lot of bloodshed on the earth and you hold yourself not accountable for it. But the Lord's gonna hold you accountable anyway. This is the reason why the Lord is beginning his punishment against you. Rejoice and be glad, O daughter of Edom. The Lord said he's gonna pass you that cup and make you drunken, man. He said, I will discover thy sins, O daughter of Edom. We read that earlier back in Lamentations 4. The Lord ain't gonna hold you guiltless, man.
Yeah. It's Nahum 1. I'm gonna start at the top. It says, the burden of Nineveh, the book of the vision of Nahum the Elkoshite, Yahweh is jealous, the Lord revenging. The Lord revenging and is furious. Yahweh by Shai will take vengeance on his adversaries and reserve his wrath for his enemies. The Lord. The Most High is jealous, and Yahweh by Shemiah Shai revenging. The Lord revenges and is furious.
He revenges and is furious. You're going to see the pinnacle of that when he returns, when he comes back with the angels. Alright? You're going to see a so-called night celestial being pissed off as ever. He's gonna be going in on you, devils. Worldwide, it's gonna be an all-out, a global, worldwide, all-out hit on Edomites by the angels. And the only ones that's gonna escape are the ones that the Lord's gonna allow to be preserved for slavery. Right?
Reserve his wrath for his enemies. The Lord Yahweh by Hashem Yahushai is slow to anger and great in power and will not at all acquit the wicked.
He's not going to exonerate you. And the fact that the Lord is still allowing you to do what you're doing. So you ain't even paid for your past iniquities going back hundreds of years ago that your forefathers would be responsible for. But even the shit that you're doing to this day, this whole depopulation agenda, you really think you're gonna get away with killing off the world's population? You know? You really think you're gonna succeed that without some form of judgment or consequence? Come to an end real soon, man. You know? Yeah, it's gonna be curtains closed, man. that will close on you in credits. Okay? And that's what that is going to end with that mushroom, the mushroom clouds. You know? The heaven shall
melt away.
Together as a scroll. You know? That's how your world is going to end.
Isaiah 34, since you said that, I'm going to start at verse 1. Come near, ye nations, to hear and hearken, ye people. Let the earth hear and all that is therein, the world and all that, the world and all things that come forth of it. But the indignation of the Lord is upon all nations, and his fury upon all their armies. He hath utterly destroyed them, he hath delivered them to the slaughter.
Prophet Isaiah speaking, he's prophesying in past tense. Think about it. It might sound ironic, but he's prophesying as if, even though this is happening into the future, it's as if it already happened. Because it's already written how the Lord is going to get the victory over this devil.
Okay.
It's already written how that war is going to end. The Lord's gonna wipe these devils smooth clean. All their military, their armies, their Navy SEALs, their Air Forces, Space Force, all that's gonna get wiped out. Okay? But the Lord, he's gonna put it in you to put up a fight because he wants a fight. But you gotta get this ass whooped, man.
Yep.
Verse 3, their slain also shall be cast out, and their stink shall come upon their carcasses.
That's those dead bodies. It's going to be as dust upon the earth. You know, dead bodies give off a aroma.
Stench.
That's how it's going to be over there in the Middle East. All those dead soldiers.
Shit.
The mountains shall be melted with their blood.
The mountains shall be melted with their blood. Alright, so hey, basically there's gonna be a lot of blood spilled. Just dead bodies all over the place. Like, remember that blast that happened last year in Lebanon with that warehouse? Yeah, I think that was a pocket nuke that was used.
It was.
It was a pocket nuke, and I believe that came from Israel.
If you slow down the missile. You slow down the video, and you can see it was a flash like in the clouds, and then this shit blew up.
Yeah.
Then we slow it down.
It looked like a mushroom cloud too.
Yeah.
When it exploded, and then when the smoke cleared, you saw a lot of dead burnt bodies. Bodies were basically burnt to a crisp, just laid out in the streets. Well, if you saw that's a preview of what it's going to be all throughout the Middle East on the day of the Lord, man.
Yeah.
You can walk through. That's how the Lord's going to basically leave those armies.
You can walk through, man. You can walk through. It's all right. You can walk through.
Verse 4, and all the host of heaven shall be dissolved, and the heavens shall be rolled together as a scroll, and all their hosts.
The heaven shall be rolled together as a scroll. Talking about like a mushroom cloud. The moment it goes up and detonates, it sends that big circle at the top. And it's just like back then when you had a scroll, like a roll. And when they would write scriptures, they would write it on a roll of paper. So when you open it up,
yeah,
or unravel it. It makes like a circular form, you know? Go ahead.
And all their hosts shall fall down as the leaf falleth from the vine, and as falleth from the fig tree. For my sword shall be bathed in heaven. Behold, it shall come down upon Idumea, and upon the people of my curse to judgment.
Who is Idumea? It's another form of saying Edomites, which Idumea, if you read the history on it,